Let's get started. I'd like to introduce KYZEN's own Global Product Line Manager, Joe McChesney.
Hello. Today, we'll be discussing the possibility of nPB being banned in your degreasing process. And if that occurs, how do you replace it? That's the big question. Federal laws governing the use of hazardous cleaning solvents such as nPB, TCE, methylene chloride, perchloroethylene, and others are regulated by both the EPA and OSHA. One such law is the Toxic Substance Control Act, better known as TSCA. In June 2018, the EPA published documents which refined the scope of risk for 10 chemicals. And of those 10 chemicals, five of them were traditional vapor degreasing solvents. And guess what was number one on the list? 1-bromopropane nPB. nPB entered the cleaning market in 1994. It was brought in as a replacement solvent for Freon and 111 Tri, which were deemed ozone depletion substances. nPB quickly spread on a global basis, and after several years of operations, some EH&S concerns arose. The EPA, OSHA, ACGIH started to conduct studies. And as a result of those studies, in 2014, the ACGIH lowered the PEL from 10 to 1/10 of a part per million. In 2018, the EPA TSCA listed nPB, as you've previously seen. And in 2020, a total ban in Europe was enacted. The EPA also listed nPB as an air toxic. So let's look at the global phase out nPB. It was sunset in July of 2020. Sunset means it no longer can be used in production. Canada is considering restrictions by the end of 2020. The fate in the United States is unknown at this time. More restrictions are expected in the Far East. And can this lead to a global ban possibility? The breaking news just out, EPA issued a report on August 20th of this year. That report contains a direct statement that has determined the use of 1BP presents unreasonable risk to human health. That's their exact words, not mine. This report contains a list of use restrictions. And in that list, vapor degreasers are called out, and they include open top, inline, and closed loop systems. This list will basically be the preliminary step in for the final report that will be issued by the EPA. We do not know exactly when that's going to be, but we estimate between 1 to 2 years from now. When this change happens, what should you do? Well, there's things you need to consider. Environmental concerns always come first. Solvent process, do you stay with solvent or you change to an alternate process? Will the change affect your throughput rate? Will the new process meet your QC requirements? And of course, all important is total cost of operations. What are your goals and requirements? Well, you want effective cleaning. You want a non-HAP solution. You want low VOC emissions. And you want a product capable of removing polar and non-polar soils. We all need a little help sometimes. Get expert advice from a business you can trust. What you're trying to find is just the right fit for your application. What do I want to accomplish? Well, obviously you want to make things better. And you do that by moving to environmentally green cleaning process. Future-proof your options. In my opinion, you only have three options. You can replace nPB with another solvent in your degreaser. And the most prominent on the market today are the transblends HFO and HFEs. And transblends may have future regulatory issues. Or you need to change to a new modern degreaser. You can convert your process from solvent to aqueous if possible. And you can convert to vacuum degreasing technology featuring modified alcohol or hydrocarbon. But whatever your choice or selection is, make sure you try to future-proof it if possible. You need to find the right financial fit. Calculate the end cost of all alternatives, the cost of compliance, the cost of quality, and the cost of operations. Look before you leap, because the cost of failure can be dramatic and disruptive in your operations. Test, test, test. Make sure you find the right fit. The disadvantages of not preparing, you could be stuck looking for an answer. Production needs, environmental compliance, and personnel safety all would suffer. KYZEN can help. And the best deal of the day, guys, our help is free. So clear your hurdles now, because while any future forecast is uncertain, the move to phase out nPB solvent is certain and underway now. Don't be caught waiting. One viable alternative is aqueous cleaning. Aqueous cleaning systems come in a wide variety, from a batch wash tank to multiple tank lines to vertical lift bed washers, spray cabinets, rotary basket washer, rotary drum washers, belt washers, all shapes and sizes and features. And however, with any change, your homework is required, because there's always advantages and disadvantages when you go to look at different systems. KYZEN can also provide technical assistance to help you in that manner. Consider vacuum degreasing for ideal performance goals. It offers excellent cleaning choice for a wide range of soils, the ability to clean and dry parts without separating them, the continuous removal of contaminants from the bath, and operator isolation from the process yields safety plus. The benefits of vacuum degreasing include ultra-low emissions, low chemical consumption, concentration of soils equals a reduced waste stream, and recycling solvent means you're not throwing away good chemistry. My personal favorite is the ability to pull a vacuum to enhance drying, reducing the carryout. So you could go from challenging parts to clean and dry parts in 9 to 15 minutes. And these are actual photos of real parts processed in a vacuum degreasing system. Create a winning synergy. Modified alcohol is formulated to provide precision cleaning in closed vacuum degreasers. It provides effective cleaning for both polar and nonpolar soils. It's a non-HAP solvent, ultra-low VOC emissions. It offers residue-free drying, and the solvent can be recycled. It provides ideal performance in a wide range and variety of parts. It meets certain ASTM specifications, and it meets environmental compliance from organizations around the world. And it's proven compliant to ISO specifications for regarding in vitro cytotoxicity for medical use. So why solvent? The old adage that solvent cleans better, faster, and more restrictive places than water can ever reach is still true. Vacuum degreasing meets the process requirements with maximum efficiency, and it yields cost-effective results. So in conclusion, plan your journey wisely and examine the alternatives. Accept the challenges that you're going to have to make some changes. Get expert advice from a business you can trust. Find the right financial choice, and in all actions, look before you leap. Thank you.
If you'd like to discuss this topic further, please contact your local KYZEN regional manager or send an email to tech2tech@kyzen.com, and we will have someone schedule a follow-up with you as soon as possible. Again, we thank you for taking the time out of your day to join us, and we hope to see you again soon. Stay safe, stay healthy, and have a wonderful day.